Hello guys, welcome back. In this video we are going to implement one use case where we will have a couple of CSV files into one directory and we will monitor that CSV files using the inputs.configuration file. So first we'll understand some important points of the inputs.configuration file and then we'll proceed to the demo. Okay, so use case is like this. Suppose we have some odd number of CSV files in a particular directory. The files can be your text files, JSON files, but in this video we are going to look for the CSV files only, and we want to continuously monitor or index that files automatically into Splunk. So yes, this is possible using the inputs.configuration file. So if you see about the input.configuration file, so this is the file which we modify or we use for the configuring your input directories, from where we can send data to the Splunk server. And there are many different stanza or configuration present in this file, but to achieve our result of our this use case, we need to use the monitor stanza that we can get it from the inputs.configuration. So all the configuration settings are present in this file, and that file is by default present at the Splunk home, etc, system and default location. So yes, as Splunk said, we don't have to modify, it is recommended not to modify this file from this default location. So we need to copy that file from default to local, either in the system local, or if you have an application or you want to index data for a particular application, in that case we can copy this file to that application's local directory. So this is the precedence we for our understanding. Splunk will look first into the system local directory, then it will look into app local directory. So we will try to keep this for our use case, we'll keep this file into the application's local directory, and let's see how we can input or index this CSV file from a directory to the Splunk. Yeah, so as I said, I have these couple of files that I want to index from this location automatically using the input slot configuration settings. Okay, so you will find this file in the system default directory. So this file will have all type of configurations applicable to the input slot configuration. So what I will do, I will copy this file and I will keep this file either in the system local directory and or applications local directory, so that Splunk will have the higher precedence on the local directory of that system or application. So I'll just put this inputs.configuration file into my application's local directory, and now let's open and see this file. So if you see, this file contains a lot of configurations which is not required for our use case. What I'll do, if you see here, you will find some couple of stanzas which are related with our requirement, like monitoring of particular directory or file set. So I'll just take this stanza. I think this is more applicable to our requirement. I'll just cut it and I'll delete the rest of content of this files, and I will paste the copied stanza here. And now I'll change the this path to my CSV files. So I'll just copy this file path of the files, and I want to index all the available CSV files. So I will add the wildcard.csv. And I know the index for you can specify the index into which index you want to add those CSV file. So the name of index, and yes, the source type is a CSV. Let's save this file. Okay, so this file is saved at applications local directory. Okay, now let's go to Splunk app to search whether the files are indexed or not. So one thing we must do, that whenever we modify any type of configuration files into the Splunk, we must restart Splunk, otherwise it will not, you know, the changes will not be applied. So after Splunk restart, let's check it again whether these CSV files are indexed or not. Yes, you can see here all these files are indexed into this Splunk. All six files are there. Okay, so this way we can monitor or index any type of files into the Splunk using the inputs.configuration file. So if you found this video useful, please do like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.